gamers. This is Psyche of the Frag Dolls. I'm here in Seattle for the Penny Arcade Expo 2008, where some of the newest and most exciting games are on display for the whole public to check out. So I have here with me Ben Mattis. He's the producer of one of the most anticipated games of 2008, The New Prince of Persia.
Yes.
Hi, Ben.
Hi, how you doing?
Is this your first Penny Arcade?
Actually, it is. I have to admit, I've been wanting to come for 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
Never made it out. Back on the Two Thrones, I was sort of hoping that was going to happen, but it didn't, so I'm pretty excited to be here.
So let's get into the game.
All right.
So what made you guys kind of pull away from the whole series, the trilogy of Prince of Persia?
Pull away from the series, I think, is sort of an exaggeration.
Okay.
We really believe that we're staying true to the Prince of Persia franchise. And a lot of people look at what we're showing them so far and they say, oh, but it's not the same prince. Or, oh, but you don't have the Sands of Time power anymore. Or, oh, you don't have those little Persian marketplace stalls. So therefore, it's not Prince of Persia. And, you know, to all of them, I basically say, you're wrong. I basically say, it is Prince of Persia. I mean, when you put your hands on this game and when you play it, you immediately get that sensation of, oh my God, everything that made me fall in love with the Prince of Persia franchise in the first place is here. I believe very strongly that that Prince of Persia feeling is
it's still there.
We have it, and we have a lot of it.
So tell us about the new look of the game, cel shading, and it's something that the gaming community is not really into. So what do you think you're bringing to the table with that?
Well, again, I would disagree.
All right, okay, that's fine.
That's fine, that's good. Okay, first of all, cel shading is, a lot of people call it cel shaded simply because they don't know what to call it. It's not realistic, it's not super cartoony, it's, oh well, what is it? It's sort of cel shaded. I mean, our game is every bit as detailed, every bit as high fidelity in terms of the resolution, the textures on the textures, the detail on the models as your Assassin's Creed, your Call of Duty, etc.
Yeah.
We just chose to make it look like this because we feel it dovetails really nicely with the fantasy, you know, style of the game.
Definitely.
We feel it works really well in terms of creating a unique visual identity for the game.
I definitely agree that it's a new style that gamers are going to get into. It just takes that easy in. So you have a new prince, you have a new storyline also. Could you tell us a little about that, how deep it is?
Sure. Well, obviously story is critical to Prince of Persia. I mean, you've got to have great story, you've got to have great characters. It's one of the brand fundamentals, one of the things people really want to, you know, really want in their Prince of Persia game. It is very important to us this time that we don't give too much of the story away because we worked really hard to make sure it's a story with a lot of hooks.
So it's deep.
It's deep. There's a lot of interesting development on the characters, both the prince and Elika. There's a lot of interesting backstory of the enemies that you're facing in the game. There's a lot of twists and turns. So what we're talking about when we talk about the story is it's the world around it, right? We talk about the backstory, you know, what sort of sets the stage for the game. But we're not really talking about much more than that because we really want the players to discover that
so
for
gonna
themselves.
There's going to be a lot of anticipation
in
the storyline.
Well, that's certainly the hope, yeah.
All right. So it looks like gamers are going to love this game. Thank you very much for the interview, and I'll see you guys later.